Louis C.K., Kevin Spacey, Jeffrey Tambor, Al Franken, Charlie Rose. The list of men being publicly outed for being creeps in the wake of the Harvey Weinstein scandal is growing daily. Emmys, Oscars, knighthoods, I mean, these are popular, beloved guys. And it turns out they're all villains. And the thing is, these men put themselves up as champions of liberal causes, as progressive allies. Like Al Franken was a Democratic senator. Meanwhile, they were jerking off in front of unsuspecting women, or unwantedly groping people, or trying to seduce a 14-year-old boy. So if you've ever been a fan of Kevin Spacey, or Louis C.K., or Al Franken, or Jeffrey Tambor, or any of these other disgraced industry big shots, how do you process this hypocrisy? I mean, I was a huge Louis C.K. fan, but now I can't watch him joke about jerking off without, you know, obviously thinking about the fact that he made a lot of people watch him jerk off. Like, he joked a lot about jerking off, and I thought it was really funny at the time, but now it feels really gross. So should we be sad that we might never get great art from these guys ever again? I guess you can't help how you feel, but what about the people they harassed or assaulted? Many of them were in the same industries as these powerful men, and these horrible incidents sometimes meant they didn't pursue careers in those industries. How many actors fled Hollywood after they were assaulted by Harvey Weinstein? How many people quit the theater because Kevin Spacey was a creep at the Old Vic? How many brilliant comedians have we been denied because Louis C.K. cornered them in a hotel room and masturbated in front of them? For every canceled Netflix deal, comedy special, or TV show, there are whole careers of people we never got to see because of what these men did. And we'll just never know how great many of these people could have been. I think it's important to recognize that these men all chose to do the things they did. Like, it's their fault. So if you're gonna blame anyone for taking away Transparent, blame Jeffrey Tambor. If I never enjoy a Louis C.K. stand-up special ever again, that is 100% on Louis C.K. Maybe this is an opportunity to become a bigger fan of someone who's not a sex pest, and that person could well be a woman.